Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Monday, Feast of the Queenship of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Our Mass Presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphone. At your right stands the Queen in robes of gold, finely arrayed.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who made the mother of your Son to be our mother and our queen, graciously grant that sustained by her intercession, we may attain in the heavenly kingdom the glory promised to your children. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwelt in the land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing, as they rejoice before you as at the harvest, as men make merry when dividing spoils. For the yoke that burdened them, the pole on their shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaster you have smashed, as on the day of Midian. For every boot that tramped in battle, every cloak rolled in blood, will be burned as fuel for flames. For a child is born to us, a son is given us, upon his shoulder dominion rests. They name him Wonder Counselor, God Hero, Father Forever, Prince of Peace. His dominion is vast and forever peaceful, from David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confirms and sustains by judgment and justice, both now and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord will give him a seat with the leaders of his people.
The Lord will give him a seat with the leaders of his people.
Praise you, servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord, both now and forever.
The Lord will give him a seat with the leaders of his people.
From the rising to the setting of the sun is the name of the Lord to be praised. High above all nations is the Lord. Above the heavens is his glory.
The Lord will give him a seat with the leaders of his people.
Who is like the Lord our God, who is enthroned on high and looks upon the heavens and the earth below?
The Lord will give him a seat with the leaders of his people.
He raises up the lowly from the dust. From the dunghill he lifts up the poor, to seat them with the princes of his own people.
The Lord will give him a seat with the leaders of his people.
Alleluia, alleluia. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you. But she was greatly troubled at what was said and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and called Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of David his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end. But Mary said to the angel, How can this be, since I have no relations with the man. And the angel said to her in reply, The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who was called barren. For nothing will be impossible for God. Mary said, Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word. And then the angel departed from her. My dear brothers and sisters, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Maybe just to better appreciate the feast that we celebrate today, the Queenship of Mary, maybe just a context, no, before we reflect on 3 points. No? The context of this feast is that this now completes the octave of the Assumption. So if you remember last Monday, diba, August 15, we celebrated the Feast of the Assumption. And remember, the other octaves that we have is the octave of Christmas and then the octave of Easter. So now you have the octave of our Blessed Mother, beginning with the Assumption and completed on this eighth day, which is the Queenship of Mary. So today we would like to reflect on that Queenship. No? The first point that I'd like to invite you to reflect on is that Mary is Queen because Christ is the King. So maybe that's the first point that I would invite you to reflect on. No? And then the second point is from the Gospel. No? It is for us to understand more deeply the meaning of her queenship. No? And then the third and final point is I'd like to read, no, an excerpt from a document, but I will put that at the very end. No? First, about Mary as the queen because her son is the king, no? Christ the king. Remember what I always say in our reflections, that one of the most beautiful portrayals of our Blessed Mother is in the movie of Mel Gibson, The Passion of the Christ. If you watch that movie again, the time that Mary is featured always in relation to her son, never apart by herself. No, that is why she is given the title the queenship. No, she is given that privilege of being the queen. And now, I think we need to remember that her being queen, her queenship, is precisely because of her sharing in the mission of her son, and that for her everything was to be the mother of the Savior. And therefore, Mary, as the mother of the Savior, nurtured her son to be able to fulfill his mission. Being fully human, remember that, no? The Lord being fully human needed that nurturance also. And Mary was most certainly one of those who nurtured him with regard to fidelity to mission and saying yes to God's will, as we heard in today's gospel. Siguro yun yung unang punto, na ang pagiging reyna ng ating mahal na birhen, siyempre mahalaga dahil ang kanyang anak ay ang hari, pero siya ay reyna dahil siya ay nakibahagi sa misyon ng kanyang anak. Na makikita natin, lalo-lalo na sa nabanggit kung sino ni Mel Gibson, The Passion of the Christ, hindi mo makikita ang mahal na birhen sa sino na yon na nakahiwalay sa misyon ng kanyang anak. That Mary is always, no, bahagi ng misyon ng ating Panginoong Hesus Kristo. Kaya nagkaroon siya ng titulo na reyna. Then the second point is that I think it's very important for us to take a look at the gospel for today, to realize that Mary's honor, no, as I said during the Feast of the Assumption, that beautiful title of Mary, you are the highest honor of our human race, is because of her fidelity to mission, because of her fidelity to be the mother of the Savior, because of her fidelity to nurture her son, for her son to discover his own mission. And we see the beginnings of that fidelity in her trust in God's word in today's gospel, wherein Mary says, no, despite the seemingly, no, ridiculous, no, or impossible thing that this angel is telling her, what does Mary say at the end after the angel says, with God all things are possible? Mary says, I am the handmaid of the Lord. I am the servant of the Lord. Let it be done to me according to your word. And with that fiat of Mary, she lived that all throughout her life with great fidelity. And this is what we also pray for, to have the same fidelity as Mary. Siguro yung pangalawang punto na yun na mahalaga natin pagnilayan, na ang masasabi natin ang pribilehyo ng Mahal na Birhen na maging reyna ay dahil siya'y naging tapat sa kanyang misyon mula sa simula hanggang sa katapusan. Ang misyon niya ay maging ina ng tagapagligtas, no? At 'yan ay isakatuparan sa krus at muling pagkabuhay. At nandoon ang Mahal na Birhen, nasa paanan ng krus. Kaya siya ay karapat-dapat na tawaging reyna ng ating pananampalataya. Nakikibahagi sa misyon na nakita natin nagsimula sa Ebanghelyo ngayong araw, yung kanyang katapatan sa kanyang oo sa misyon na binigay sa kanya ng Ama. Then the third and final point is, I'd like to read this section. I will not tell you where it came from until I finish reading it, no? Following upon the frightful calamities which before our very eyes have reduced flourishing cities, towns, and villages to ruins, we see to our sorrow that many great moral evils are being spread abroad in what may be described as a violent flood. Occasionally, we behold justice giving way, and on the one hand and the other, the victory of the powers of corruption. The threat of this fearful crisis fills us with a great anguish, and so with confidence we have recourse to Mary our Queen, making known to her those sentiments of filial reverence which are not ours alone, but which belong to all those who glory in the name of Christian. End of quote. Para hong sinulat para ngayong mga kapanahunan, no? It seems that this particular passage was written for now, 2022. But this passage was written in 1954 when Pope Pius XII declared the queenship of Mary. And I think that is one thing that I invite you to reflect on. Mary, during different stages of our human history, always, in a sense, made the message of her son known again. Of course, you have one of the most famous appearances, Fatima, probably one of the appearances that has a global impact, no, with the devotion to Fatima. But I think it is part of our, in a sense, faith system and our spirituality that Mary always comes to us during moments of need. And many, many apparitions are really within the context of a very specific historical need within a very specific time. And now as we go through this crisis of the pandemic, we turn to our Blessed Mother and ask us to accompany us, to help us emerge from this pandemic and to overcome all the injustices and evils of the world. Hilingin natin sa ating Mahal na Birhen na siyang laging dumadating sa ating mga pangangailangan sa larangan ng kasaysayan, maraming pagkakataon na ang Mahal na Birhen ay nagpapakita sa atin at inuulit ang mensahe ng kanyang anak. And so today, let us continue and let us pray fervently to our Blessed Mother to pray with us, to help us continue the mission of her son, and to place us with her son. Let us pray to God our Father, who accomplished great things in Mary and brought her to the glorious throne in heaven. We make known to him our needs through the aid of Mary. To each prayer, a response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
That like Mary, the Church may bear witness to the saving love of Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That governments may listen to the voice of God in the Church calling for an end to economic inequalities that now exist between peoples and nations, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That like Mary, we may be constant in prayer and in seeking to fulfill God's plan for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. And today on the feast day of our Blessed Mother, let us commend all of these prayers to our Blessed Mother. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
At sabay-sabay natin dasalin ngayon ang ating prayer for our nation. Panginoon ng kasaysayan, sa aming paghahanda para sa 125th anibersaryo ng pagsilang ng aming bansa, sabayan mo po kami sa aming proyekto na magtatag ng 1,000 lipunang may tunay na kalayaan para sa lahat. Kalayaang nakaugat sa pagkalinga, hustisya at katotohanan. Kalayaan mula sa kahirapan na nag-aalis mula sa nakararami ng pagkakataong mapabuti ang kanilang buhay. Kalayaan mula sa gutom, kawalan ng tirahan at kakulangan ng dekalidad ng mga simpleng serbisyo sa pangangalaga ng kalusugan at sa edukasyon. Kalayaan mula sa panlilinlang, kasinungalingan at manipulasyon. Kalayaan upang maging mga aktibo at positibong tagapagbuo ng aming bansa. Bigyan mo kami ng katatagan ng loob at inspirasyon na walang humpay na itaguyod ang isang bansang tunay na malaya para sa lahat ng mga Pilipino. Amen. By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness we have this bread and this wine to offer. Fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, they will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
As we observe the memorial of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we bring you our offerings, O Lord, praying to be given strength by the humanity of Christ, who offered himself to you on the cross as the unblemished oblation, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds and exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to earth's ends, you have done great things and extended our abundant mercy from age to age. When you looked on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us through her, the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the choirs of angels adore your majesty, and rejoices in your presence forever as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember, Father most holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us offer our prayer for an end to the pandemic and for the rebuilding of our nation.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we humbly come to you to find forgiveness and life. We come to ask for your grace and guidance as we emerge from this pandemic. Bless all those who help see us through the challenges the pandemic brought, those who tirelessly work to render genuine service, especially to those who suffered the most. Guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission and to end this pandemic. Heal all who are afflicted. Grant eternal rest to those who died and consolation to their loved ones. As we move forward, grant us the grace to see clearly, choose well, and act right in order to build a nation closer to your kingdom of justice, truth, equality, faith, hope, compassion, and love. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not deny our petition, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Roch,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu,
have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy,
have mercy on us. And let us pray. Having received this heavenly sacrament, we humbly pray, O Lord, that we who reverently celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Virgin Mary may merit to be partakers of your eternal banquet through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We will offer first the prayer for peace and joy for our world. Father in heaven, to you we offer this prayer in the words of our Holy Father, Pope Francis. We have so much to do and we must do it together. In the darkness of the conflicts we are living through, each of us can become a bright candle to remind us that light will overcome darkness and never the other way around. To us Christians, the future has a name, and its name is hope. It is the virtue of the heart that does not lock itself up, does not dwell on the past, and not only survives the present, but is able to see tomorrow. Bless our world, Father, with the peace and joy that the cross and resurrection of your Son, our Lord Jesus, won for us. For all those affected by calamities natural and man-made, for all those who suffer from the structural injustices of our time, amen. Our Lady, Mother of God, and Mother of the Church,
pray for us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Marami pong salamat. Have a good day ahead and have a good week ahead. And then happy feast of our Blessed Mother, the Queen of our faith.
Pilipinas ay isa sa mga bansang nakakaranas ng iba't ibang kalamidad. Sa loob ng isang taon, ay meron tayong humigit-kumulang sa 20 bagyo na dumadaan sa ating bansa. Madalas ding mayroong pagguho ng lupa, malawakang baha, lindol, sunog at iba pa. Sa kasalukuyan ay mas pinalala pa ito dahil sa pandemya. Isa sa mga gawain ng Caritas Philippines ay ang pangunahan ang pagtugon ng mga pangangailangan ng naapektuhang kalamidad ng iba't ibang humanitarian crisis. Ang Caritas ay nagbibigay ayuda sa pamamagitan ng emergency relief assistance. Bukod sa emergency relief, nagbibigay rin tayo ng ayuda para sa early recovery ng mga komunidad na naapektuhan, tulad ng pagbibigay ng pabahay at kabuhayan. Kasama din dito ang iba't ibang capacity building and community organizing upang maihanda ang mga diocese at komunidad. Tayong lahat ay magkaisa, mag-alay kapwa para sa alay sa katugunan sa kalamidad.